Hi, have you ever worked with network devices? They offer so many fantastic advantages. The only thing is, if you're not familiar with network configuration settings, the first contact can be a bit of a challenge. First of all, with IPv6, the more modern protocol for network addressing, everything would be much easier. However, IPv6 is still not accepted everywhere, so we have to use today's standard, IPv4. IPv4 has this format, which might look familiar to you. It uses 32-bit addresses, which limits the address space to roughly 4.3 billion addresses. That's a lot. But if you imagine how many network devices are out there, you immediately realize that this is by far not enough. The reason why we can still work with this principle is that there is a differentiation between public and private addresses. There are some ranges that are reserved for private use, means within a local network, so at home, in your office, or within an entire company. The remaining addresses are for public use, for web servers, which should be reachable within the entire internet. A gateway with two addresses, one for each side, is the interface between these two worlds. At home, that's usually your router's job. If you want to communicate with a network device, even if it's just a simple direct connection, it's crucial to understand which addresses you can reach from where and how devices can get their addresses. As soon as you have an Ethernet interface on the device, there is a configuration somewhere, and this configuration has an influence on which addresses you can reach and which not. If you connect the device to your computer but the address ranges don't match, you can't communicate, although you know the address of the device you want to talk to. Most Kistler network devices can be found with the network setup wizard. It finds and lists the Kistler network devices which are reachable through all your network interfaces. It is vital though that the devices already have an IP address. There are some situations where this can take a while, but later more about this. There are basically three ways how devices can get an IP address. Someone gives them specific static addresses. A so-called DHCP server provides IP addresses to new devices in the network. Or devices just pick an IP address themselves if there is no DHCP server. This is then called AutoIP. Static addressing is like if someone moves into an apartment in the same building as you. The family gets a fixed apartment number, and whenever someone's home, they can be reached by this apartment number. Static IP addresses are great for direct connections or very small networks where not too many equipment changes happen. The devices are then very quickly accessible as soon as they're up and running and connected. You have to make sure though that not only the devices, but also your computer has a static address in the same address range. Otherwise, no communication. You also can't just walk to an apartment in another building when the main door is locked. Inside your own building, you can easily walk to your neighbor's door and communicate. DHCP addressing is like when people come into a hotel. The receptionist gives them a room, and afterwards you can reach them when you know in which room they stay. If they come back a month later, it's possible that the receptionist gives them a different room, but the procedure is the same. In a bigger network, in an office or lab, for example, where you connect the device to the office network, DHCP is very convenient and usually the standard configuration. A new device immediately gets an address, and since your computer is already in this network, you can definitely reach the new device after you found it with the setup wizard. At home, your router does the job of the DHCP server. AutoIP is like if you drive to a town, but there's just no one around who could give you a hotel room. You then decide to go to a camping site and just place your tent there and tell your friends that you stay there. In the network context, if there is no DHCP server available after around 1 minute, the device just picks an IP address. This is convenient for occasional connections when you just set up something once, perform the measurement, and then put it away for a longer while. But also here, the configuration of your PC's interface has to match with that. AutoIP can be configured as a backup for DHCP. If the PC's Ethernet adapter is on static configuration, it is very likely that you can't communicate with such an AutoIP address. I know these were very quick explanations, but the most important thing is always make sure that settings of your PC's network adapter and the network settings of your devices match. You find your PC settings usually if you look for Ethernet adapter settings. What can also help if you don't want to change any settings on your computer is such an Ethernet to USB converter. Well then, happy Ethernet configurations. See you.